when we were first approached to design what we call a PRD, or a personal radiation detector, the question was, what type of detector should we use? And we settled on a scintillation-based technology. That means it basically sparks or lights up. So inside of our instrument is a small tube that has a cesium iodide crystal in it. And the cesium iodide is grown kind of like salt. We mount a photo detector or a light detector on top of it. When gamma radiation strikes that crystal, it's like it sparks or it lights up. There's an interaction with that particular material and gamma radiation or radioactivity. And so what we do with that light sensor is we sense what's going on. How many strikes are we getting? How many rays, gamma rays, are we detecting? And so the more it's sparking or lighting up, the brighter it glows. So understanding how to characterize what's happening with that detector is an engineering challenge, and understanding all the math and the algorithms that go into detecting and identifying radiation.
For the small size of the PCB design, we have to get a lot of circuitry into a small space, and it also needs to be protected. It's very sensitive, so we have to make sure that there's no interference from one signal to the next. I enjoy a challenging job with some kind of artistic flair to it. I think that for a lot of designers, there is a bit of an artist in each of us that makes us want to design, route, and lay out that circuit board so that it not only functions properly, but it looks nice and neat as well.
Please give us a like and share the video, and don't forget to subscribe. We'd love to hear what you think, so please leave a comment in the section below.